Hey all, welcome to homeschool, and we are with a wonderful chapter called Soil, where we have started studying many things, right? In my just previous video, we studied about a percolation rate of water in a soil. So percolation rate in the sense, in how much speed, in how much time the water actually can easily penetrate or move into the soil. That is what we studied, and we got to know how to calculate percolation rate with the help of formula. Everything we discussed. And I also gave a slight introduction about absorption of water, isn't it? And what is absorption here? Absorption in the sense, ability, it is the ability of soil to hold the water, or to absorb the water. Yes or no? That is what we call it as absorption of water in a soil. Okay, how nicely soil can hold the water with itself without leaving the water. How nicely it can hold with it. That is what we mean by absorption of water. Okay. Say this particular activity also helps us to understand about absorption of water. Okay. We can able to decide which type of a soil can absorb water very nicely. Okay. So absorption is just opposite to percolation. Percolation means what? How nicely water can flow and come out through soil. But absorption is how nicely soil can hold the water without leaving it. Okay. It will grab the water with itself. That capacity is absorption. Okay. So you have to be very, very careful in understanding the words called percolation and absorption. Both are opposite. Okay, both have opposite meanings actually, not same. Clear? Fine. So here you have a sandy soil in the first case, clay soil in the next case, third case loamy soil. Say sandy soil, you are pouring water. See, entire amount of water you got it in a beaker. That means here percolation is very high. Movement of water through particle is very high. The soil is not holding the water. That's why the entire amount of water has collected in this beaker. Right? That means what I can say? Sandy soil do not absorb the water. Okay? Absorption capacity of sandy soil is very less. Can I write that point here? So very important point. Note it down all this. Absorption capacity of sandy soil is very less. Yes or no? Percolation is very high. That is why absorption is very less, guys. Wherever you see water movement in a soil quickly, there you will actually absorb. Absorption being very, very less. Okay. Since there are so many gaps between the sand particles, water easily flows. Water easily moves. But the particles cannot hold the water, cannot absorb the water. Right. So that is why I said absorption capacity of sandy soil is very less. So which soil can absorb water very nicely? Which soil can hold the water very nicely? That is our clay soil. Yes or no? Because you see in this particular activity, when you pour amount of water into a pot containing clay soil, very little water got collected in the beaker that you kept down. That means, say if you have poured 200 ml of water, only 2 ml of water got collected. That means remaining 198 ml of water is there in a soil. The soil is holding that water. Water is not moving down. Soil is holding that water. Right? Soil has absorbed that water. So, what I can write here is absorption capacity. एब्जॉर्प्शन कैपेसिटी ऑफ क्ले सॉइल इज वेरी हाई, वेरी हाई. ओके, सो दिस वन यू मस्ट रिमेंबर केयरफुली. सो विच सॉइल हैज मोर एब्जॉर्प्शन कैपेसिटी एंड विच सॉइल हैज लेस एब्जॉर्प्शन कैपेसिटी. Percolation power, which soil has more rate of percolation? Sandy soil. Which soil has less rate of percolation? Clay soil. Yes or no? You shouldn't get confused. Percolation has opposite meaning to absorption. Clear? Fine. So now, actually, you can calculate percentage of absorption. Okay? So to how much extent water has been absorbed by a soil, that you can calculate. Just in case of previous class, you calculated how fast the percolation can take place in a different soil. You know, you calculated with the help of a formula. Similarly, how nicely absorption takes place, to what extent absorption takes place, can be calculated with the help of a formula. Okay? And let us derive that formula with the help of one simple activity. Yeah, fine. So what I will do here is, look at here, I will take one beaker. I'm taking one beaker, okay, empty beaker. This is an empty beaker initially. So to this empty beaker, I am introducing one funnel. Okay, so I will introduce some funnel. Let me draw with a red pen. This is a funnel, glass funnel. Okay, glass funnel. Fine. And in this glass funnel, I will put one filter paper. Okay, one newspaper, you can make it in the shape of a cone. Okay, one newspaper, you can make it in the shape of a cone and put it in the funnel. Okay, say here in this newspaper, I will take 50 grams of soil. Right, let me label. This is beaker. This is funnel. This blue color one is filter paper. Filter paper. Filter paper is the one which has small holes, guys. Through the holes, if I pour water, you know, it will come out. So in that filter paper, what I took? I took 50 grams of soil. I took some amount of soil you can take. Okay, fine. And what happens here is, I will start pouring water slowly with the help of dropper. Okay, slowly I will start pouring water with the help of dropper. Okay, through the dropper, water is falling onto the soil. Okay, slowly. So let me take around some amount of water. Okay, some amount of water I am pouring it onto a soil. What happens? Slowly some amount of water is absorbed by a soil and remaining amount of water will start collected in this beaker. Yes or no? Right, so this is what the activity I have done. I took a beaker, I took one glass funnel. In the funnel I kept one filter paper. Inside a filter paper, I filled some amount of soil here. I took about 50 grams of soil. And slowly I am pouring water from top with the help of dropper. Okay. And you know, some amount of water definitely gets absorbed by soil. Okay. The soil holds some amount of water. Whatever water extra is there, that will fall into a beaker. Okay. Now, imagine, here, weight of a soil. How much is the weight of a soil taken? Weight of a soil taken is equal to 50 grams. Isn't it? Okay. Weight of a soil taken is equal to 50 grams here. Right. And now, volume of water. Okay, or I will say it as initially. Okay, first, like how much amount of water that you added from dropper, that is what we call initial volume of water taken is equal to UML. Okay, some UML. If you take 200 ml, that is your U value. Okay, so initial volume of water taken is equal to UML, right? And the amount of water that is there finally, that is collected in a beaker, is called VML. So what I'll write here is final volume of water is equal to VML. Okay, fine. So understood now all this? How much is the total weight of a soil you took? 50 grams. How much is the total water you added here? That is initial volume, UML. And how much water is left out here? That is VML. Okay. So with the help of, if you know all these values, if you know how much amount of soil you took, here it is 50 grams. If you know how much is the total water you added with the help of a dropper. If you know how much, if you can measure how much water is collected in a beaker. If you know all these values, you know, you can calculate percentage absorption of water. What we can calculate? Percentage absorption of water. That means how much water has been absorbed by the soil in case of percentage. You know, that you can calculate with the help of a formula, U minus V divided by weight of soil. Okay, weight of soil. Got it? So this is the formula to calculate percentage absorption of water. Clear everybody? So what is U here? U is nothing but initial volume. Like in the starting, how much amount of water you added onto a soil with the help of a dropper. That is U value. What is V value? How much water is left out. That is V value. Okay. So U minus V. What is U minus V tells you? U minus V is nothing but, if you subtract U minus V, you know, is nothing but amount of water absorbed by the soil. Okay, yes or no? So when you subtract this minus this, U minus V, you know, you will get amount of water absorbed by the soil. Clear everybody? So this is what the formula that you have to remember. Percentage absorption of water is equal to U minus V divided by weight of soil into 100, because we are calculating its percentage, right? So definitely you should add into 100. Clear? So do not forget this formula. Copy the formula. Now we will see one example regarding this. Look at the question here. I have given some details. Weight of a soil 50 grams, initial volume of water, that is U, initially from the dropper, how much ever water I am adding to the soil, that is 100 ml of water I am adding. Final volume, the water that collected here, some amount would have absorbed. The water that have collected here is 50 ml. Calculate percentage absorption. So what is the formula here? U minus V divided by weight of soil into 100, right? What is U value? U value is 100 minus V value is how much? 50, right? Weight of soil is how much? 50 into 100. Okay, so how much do you get? 100 minus 50? 50. 50 by 50 into 100, right? That means how much, guys? It is 100%. Yes or no? So what is the answer here? See, this and this gets cancelled. So what remains? 100%, right? So how much is the absorption capacity? How much is the percentage absorption here? 100%, right? So this is how you can calculate with the help of a formula. Clear? So anyway, the problems and all will not be asked about a formula. You just have to remember the meaning of the formula. You must know what is U and what is V, right? So this is important to remember here. So that's all about absorption ability of water in a soil. So remember, which soil has more absorption capacity? Clay soil. Which soil has least absorption capacity? Sandy soil. So this is important to remember, right? So let us go for the next property, moisture content in a soil. Coming to the last property of a soil, that is moisture in a soil. So we all very well know that soil has moisture content in it. Yes or no? What do you mean by moisture? What do you mean by moisture content? It is nothing but water content. So there is little amount of water content in every type of a soil. Okay? In it. Fine. And actually, what is the proof that there is water content in a soil? You know, let me ask you one question here. During summer, farmland, agricultural land, in case if no crop is there, farmland shines. Actually, what do you mean by farmland shines? The air above the farmland, the air above land shimmers in the sense shines, right? So why? Why does this happen? Can you tell me why does this happen? Understood the question clearly? During summer, farmland shines. Farmland, land shining in the sense, the air that is present above the soil shimmers or shines. So why is this happening? What is the reason behind it? It is because, I'm writing the answer here. It is because moisture is present. Okay, so imagine this is a soil. So this is a surface of earth and where you have a topsoil. Okay, so there would be little amount of water content here. So the moment, hot summer in the sense what, guys? There is lot of sunlight. The climate is very much hot, yes or no? Say, to that hotness, when the climate is very much hot, what happens? The water that is there inside a soil will come out in the form of vapors. Okay? So what is happening here? Water comes out in form of vapor. Okay. So, and you know, the sunlight, when it falls on this vapor, okay, imagine sunlight will fall everywhere. Sunlight, when it touches these vapors, these vapors are, you know, the air present above the soil will reflect the sunlight. It will reflect these vapors actually. It will reflect. The air is getting reflecting. Okay, sunlight. That's the reason what happens. The farmland shines or the air above the soil is shining or shimmering. Got to know? So this is the answer. So why? Actually, moisture is present. Since moisture is present to that hot climate, the water is getting vaporized. Okay, so when it is getting vaporized, you know, it will reflect the sunlight. Okay, so what is happening here? Reflecting the sunlight. Because of this reflection of sunlight, you know, the air appears shiny above the soil. Okay, so that's why farmland shines. When you see from far away position, if you see a farmland, you know, it looks shiny. The air above the land shimmers. It shines. It's all because of this process. Okay. So, the vapors which is coming out from a soil is actually reflecting the sunlight. So this is the reason why farmland shines or shimmers. Fine. And actually, what is the proof that there is moisture content present in a soil? How do you prove it? So I am asking you, what is the proof for the presence of moisture in a soil? Presence of moisture in a soil. So you can always prove something with the help of experiment. Okay. So imagine you take a test tube, a small test tube, and you fill a test tube with soil. I am taking any kind of soil, it may be. Okay. So here you have a soil. And I'll start heating from the bottom. Okay. So what I'll do? I'll start heating. Okay, I'll give some amount of flame with a Bunsen burner, right? When I start heating, whatever water content is there in this, you know, it will come out as vapor and it will touch the sides of container. There it will appear as water droplets. Okay, this vapor that is coming from the soil, when it touches the sides of a container, you know, the vapor is nothing but gas. When gas is condensed, it becomes a liquid. Okay. So when this gas touches the container and that particular vapor is getting converted back into water droplets. Okay. Water droplets. If you have water content in the soil, then only onto the sides you will observe water droplets. If there were no water, you don't observe any water droplets. Yes or no? Because water content is there, when you started heating, it is coming out, that water content is coming out as vapor. It is touching onto the sides of the test tube and that vapor is getting converted back into water droplets, right? It is all because there is moisture in a soil. If that moisture was not there, do you observe these water droplets onto a side of a test tube? Never, right? Okay, so you will observe that vapor coming out only because moisture is there. Say this experiment actually proves the presence of moisture in a soil. Okay, so that's all about the properties of a soil. We studied percolation rate, that is in the last class. And in this video, we studied about absorption of water in a soil and moisture in a soil. Okay, so meet up in the next class. Till then, revise the concept, subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in the easiest way and in a detailed way. Thank you.